And now from the 8 on Your Side team and the debate about selling the state liquor stores. The idea of forcing customers to take a breathalyzer test to buy a bottle of wine at the grocery store is still being discussed. And Pennsylvania shoppers still are not warming up to it. Now we've learned the state had a warning that the program could run into trouble. An internal memo from the Pennsylvania Liquor Control Board shows the state agency spent hundreds of thousands of dollars to develop the controversial wine kiosk program, despite that warning. 8 on Your Side government reporter Matt Belanger is here with the details on that. Matt?
Now, Brian, good evening. Remember these things that the state-supported wine kiosks are still operating in some stores across Pennsylvania. They allow consumers to buy wine at grocery store locations instead of state-run wine and spirit stores. But shoppers, as you mentioned, have to blow into a breathalyzer. The whole transaction is monitored remotely with a little camera by a state employee. And now these kiosks have become the latest focus of the privatization debate.
In this 2008 memo, an evaluation committee, which reviewed the company Simple Brands' proposal to create and operate wine kiosks, determined the company's plan to be deficient and urged against the state entering into contract negotiations. But the PLCB did it anyway. Agency leaders now say they plan to work out concerns with the contract. But Pennsylvania's consumers have resisted using the automated machines that require buyers to swipe their IDs and blow into breathalyzers to be able to buy a bottle of wine at the same time as groceries.
Matt, when you're explaining in this business, you're losing, and the PLCB just never fails to fail.
Jay Ostrich with the conservative policy group, the Commonwealth Foundation, says the kiosks are another example of why the state should get out of the business of selling alcohol. He says investors in the company awarded the contract had donated hundreds of thousands of dollars to then-Governor Ed Rendell.
Awarding a single bid contract to campaign cronies when your own people are telling you not to do it isn't just fishy, it's a failure.
Ostrich shares views with a group of Republican lawmakers at the state capitol who are pushing to privatize the sale of wine and liquor in Pennsylvania. The plan would scrap the state-run wine and spirits stores and take the people who work in them off of the state payroll. It would then auction licenses to businesses for the right to sell wine and liquor and overhaul the state's alcohol tax system with a tax per gallon based on alcohol content. News 8 political analyst Dr. Terry Madonna.
It is still by no means a done deal that the Pennsylvania Liquor Control Board operation will cease and that the state will privatize the sale of alcohol.
Yeah, meanwhile, the state's standing behind the kiosks, saying in a statement to News 8 today, the, quote, the PLCB will continue to move forward with the program in good faith. That also comes after Wegmans grocery stores, which had first welcomed the machines, asked the state to pull them, citing customer complaints. And Brian, you'll remember, wasn't that long ago, we were reporting on the possibility of putting hard liquor, you know, vodka in these machines. Mm-hmm. But it appears at this point, as this privatization debate unfolds, that effort has kind of cooled a little bit. You could say it's on hold.
You could say it's in the dark, it sounds like. All right, thank you, Matt. Mm-hmm.